The purpose of this video is to show you how to renew a COR400000 permit, the online construction stormwater permit, within the CO system. So your first step will be to get logged in if you already have your COS account. Do that from the public login page, enter your username and password and click login. If you don't already have an account, please create one here under that create a new account option. So select login. And then it'll take you to this landing page. You can either associate slash create a facility or go to your dashboard. In this case, let's go to our create a facility page. So on this page, you'll be able to see any facilities that you've already associated with. If you have an active permit that you applied for within COS, it should already appear on this page, in which case you are good to go as far as a renewal application. I'll show you the next steps there. If you don't see your permitted facility on this page, you need to start by associating it with your account, which you can do by clicking Associate Facility and then searching the exact facility name on your permit here. And then leave all of the other fields blank and click Search. Once found, you'll check a box for Online Construction Stormwater Permit. The other status that matters on this page is that your facility is active. If it says pending, it means that you haven't yet completed either E-Verify or an ESA. Or if it says inactive, it means that another responsible official in the system likely replaced you, which inactivated you, in which case, please just give us a call and we can sort that out with you. So once you're active for your permitted facility, go ahead and go to the Submittal tab. This is a responsible official's account. Please note RO. If you have a preparer account, there's a couple of additional steps that I'll get to in a second. So under the Submittal tab, find the Manage Permit slash Certs page. And then you'll find your permitted facility here, as well as that permit number and the blue action button. If the action button is grayed out, hover over it and it'll tell you why or where the application is. So in this case, it's blue. I'll click on it. It'll give you a pop-up where you can select the action that you want to complete. For renewals, you'll select Renew, click OK. This will launch the renewal application for you. Click Next. It should autofill if you applied for your permit within COS originally. If your permit predated COS, you'll have to enter in the information. Treat this like a new permit application, meaning if you want to update any of the contacts, you can do so, or the acreage or dates or anything. All of those fields are editable to you. The only case that would require a separate action would be if you're transferring the permit between companies. So if the company is changing for either the owner or the operator, please submit a transfer application first. Once that's approved, you can do the renewal. Otherwise, just make all changes on the form. So once everything's filled out, click Next. And then there is a requirement for you to attach a map of your site. And then click Next. It'll give you a green check mark showing that you've completed all of the required fields as well as that required attachment. And then to submit, you'll need a signature from the owner and the operator that you listed on the application. So in this case, I'm going to go back to the form on the left-hand side under data entry. Go ahead and check what name you had for the owner and the operator. And make sure to update them so that they match exactly the names that will be signing the application. So in this case, the signature is going to come through as Haley McNutt. We need it to be Haley McNutt, not Haley CDPHE, but Haley McNutt listed on the application. In your case, it'll be whoever is the operator of the site and whoever is the owner of the site going forward will need to be the two names. Sometimes these are different people and sometimes they're the same. If they are different people, both will need a COS RO account and will need to be associated with this facility. Save that change and then either click Next or navigate using that left-hand panel. And again, we had green check marks. Since on this application, I am the owner and the operator, I'll want to select my own name because you'll need two signatures on a stormwater permit application. And then answer the security question and your PIN. Check the I hereby certify that I am box. Click certify. That is your digital signature. You can verify that your signature went through by checking the certified date column. In this case, there's a date there, so it means that I signed. If there wasn't a date there, then you some step was missing. Check the banner at the top for an error message. So once you've certified, you're ready to submit, which is the same exact step. Use the checkbox, enter your question answer, and the PIN. But again, make sure both the owner and the operator have certified before you submit. So once all of that's entered, click Submit. The system will change to submitting while it processes. And this step can take a minute or two. Once your submission has gone through, you'll receive this submittal receipt with your submittal ID on it. Please take note of that number if you are to call in to ask any status updates or questions about the report or the application. You'll need that number to help us direct us to it. And then when you go to your dashboard at this point, you'll be able to see that under the department items list, meaning it's in our court to process instead of the my pending items list. So this does not mean that your permit has been renewed automatically. It just means that your application to renew has been submitted and is now under admin review. So please reference this page for any status updates. And keep an eye on your email that you set your account up under for the letter that states your permit is being renewed or that your application was approved, as well as any information about your updated permit. And that is it. If anything is wrong with the renewal application, the permit team will send it back to you, in which case it'll be moved back to the My Pending Items list and be highlighted in red, where you can edit and then resubmit, which it'll move back to the department items list. If you have any questions, please send them to either one of the following email addresses. Thank you.